What's good, YouTube? Welcome to A-Side Boxing. It's your boy, Trilly Trills. And on this episode, I'm going to get into a little segment I like to call the DON, the Division on Notice. Stay tuned. So, on this episode of A-Side Boxing Talk, as I said, we're going to get into this Don series, or the Division on Notice. So, as you could probably see by the thumbnail, we talking about the young killer in the 140 division, in the super lightweight division, and that's Gary Antoine Russell. This young man got 14 wins, 0 losses, and 14 stoppages, man. He recently just... He ate up, man. He fought Giovanni Santiago, who was a recent, or whose previous opponent was Adrian Broner. He gave Adrian Broner, he won a lot of rounds in that Adrian Broner fight. Some people even thought that the guy won and beat Adrian Broner. But let me tell you this, man. That boy, Gary Antoine Russell, was not playing with it, man. He went in there, he did his thing, and he got him up out of there. Actually stopped him on a stool in 6. So, yes, he does have the 140 division on notice. So one thing let's talk about it. Let's get into it. So he's ranked number 5 in the WBA, and what's very, very important about that to me is that who just became undisputed in at 140, Mr. Josh Taylor, right? So if I can predict or see things the right way, I think that Mr. Josh Taylor won a fight with Bud Crawford, right? So, if Josh Taylor go on to fight Bud Crawford, what happens to all 4 of them belts? Yes, the rings, the belts get spread across the land. And guess what? My man is ranked at number 5. The WBA know what's up. That's why they got him ranked that high. So guess what? If I think that Gary Antoine Russell is going to be in title contention next year, 2022, latest the beginning of 2023, he is going to be in there for a title shot. And they, oh man, this guy, man, listen, this guy's a bruiser, man. He's a punisher. But the one thing about him, and what I like to use to describe his style, I call his style, and you know, when I put my little shake on it, I call Gary Antoine Russell style the tech press style, because he's a technical fighter. He has the footwork. He leads with the jab. He can give you every punch in the book. You know what I'm saying? He has all the intangibles of a great fighter. But he's gonna press you. He's gonna press you out. If you cannot fight off the back foot, you're gonna lose. And that's what he's been proving. He go in there and he gonna come at you, and he's gonna be in your chest for 3 minutes each round. He don't take no time off. He not gonna bullshit with you. He not gonna play. He's gonna go in there. The dude's fast. His footwork is crazy. And he hits, punches, not hits. He punches hard as shit. Get, man, listen, I'm high on this dude. I'm telling you, I'm high on this dude, man. Gary Antoine Russell is no joke. Hopefully we could see him in there with an Adrian Broner next. I wouldn't mind seeing him in there with a Regis Prograde next, to be honest with you, man. I really think that this dude is ready for everybody at 140. What the next fight may be, I think I could see him fighting in a WBA. I think it's like a German guy named like Batir Akhmadov, one of them guys. He's a really good fighter, overseas fighter. But I just don't see nobody stopping Gary Antoine Russell, man. He a dog, man. And man, I like his style, man. The way him and brothers come out, man. I love all of that, man. I love the way them guys move as a unit. The Russell family. You know what? Let's talk about the Russell family for a little minute, man. These guys personify Black excellence. These guys personify what the family dynamic should look like, man. You know, they're model family, man. Them guys stick together. No one man is above the group. And to be honest, Mr. Gary Russell Jr. is really should be on everybody top 10 pound for pound list, but it just seemed like he's getting freezed out over there at PBC. I don't know why. I don't know his business dealings, but Mr. Gary Russell Jr., he a dog. Fucking dog. You know what I'm saying? One of the best fighters in boxing today, and it's just a little sad, and I hate to see that he's not fighting like he should. Mr. Gary Russell should be fighting 2, 3, 4 times a year, but it's like we barely see him. But you know what? Let me get back to Gary Antoine. Either way, man, Gary Antoine ain't no joke, man. Like I said, should be in title contention, man. 140, he a beast, man. He done stopped everybody, but he shows that he's a boxer. You know what I'm saying? He shows. He's what, if he wasn't black, they'd say he got the Mexican style. But like I said, to me, I call it the tech press, the technical pressure style. You understand what I'm saying? He's gonna pressure you. He goes to the, he invests, man. I don't know about Bitcoin, but that boy definitely invests to the body. That's a fact. He invested them shots to the body. He going to the body, he coming back up. He good with changing his levels, man. He stick that jab in front of you. 2-3 jabs, not just one jab. He's a combination puncher. Fast as shit, man. But that's what them Russells are known for. And he'll mess around and knock you out in a pair of Jordans too, man. So, you know what I'm saying, man? Like I said, man, this guy has put the WBA and the 140 division on notice. He's ranked number 5, and they better stay clear, man. I don't see, and I hope it don't go like this, but I don't see nobody just willingly taking a fight with him. They're gonna duck him. Your best fighters, your favorite fighters at 140 pounds are gonna duck him. I promise you. They're gonna have to pay guys. They're gonna have to overpay guys to get in there. But you know what I'm saying, man? Either way, this is the this is my first segment of the Don series. D-O-N. The Division on Notice. And we just featured Gary Antoine Russell, man. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe, and tell a friend to tell a friend. It's Trilly Trills, ASAP Boxing. I'm out.